Where is it? I know you were trying to keep it for yourself, Chizar. You always try to keep it for yourself. No, there's got to be more Skooma. Shut up! Shut up! Don't lie to me, Chizar. You hid it. You always try to steal it.
Another of the school skins looking for food? This one was entrapping us.
No! You must be the one who took my Skooma! You're dead!
bring the face.
What was that? Someone there.
Time to end this little game. You're a dead man!
Thank you. What was that? Over here!
Lot to do around the farm, so make it quick, please. What is it you wanted? Actually, I'm growing it, if you hadn't noticed. I'm the only person alive that can cultivate Nirnroot from a seed to a fully grown plant. Yes, he was an absolute genius when it came to the Nirnroot. Sindarin made it his life's work, developing all sorts of interesting concoctions. I used to be. There isn't much time for that in my life anymore, I'm afraid. I actually owned a shop in Vivek City long ago, but I had to leave all that behind when the Red Mountain erupted. Perhaps someday I'll reopen a shop here in Skyrim. I knew this day would eventually come. At least poor Sindarin died doing what he loved, his field research. I told the old fool he should take it easy, but He was too stubborn. Perhaps someday I'll continue where he left off. It's the least I can do, considering how much he did for me. You gathered quite a few of them, I see. I'll search through Sindarian's notes and find some more information about the Crimson Nirnroot and its properties. Thank you. You've done alchemy a great service by helping to complete Sindarian's work. I'd like to give you this tome. It's one of Sindarian's greatest works. I believe you've more than earned it. When I was very young, I was sent to Skingrad in Cyrodiil to study with him. He was a strange Altmer. Paid more attention to his research than his own well-being. He lived in the basement of an inn, for goodness sakes. Well, after I fled Morrowind during the eruption, I made my way here. My family had purchased this farm, and it's all we had left. Years later, Sindarian simply showed up at our doorstep asking to stay for a while. Said he was going to do field research. He stayed with us for decades. Became an uncle of sorts to Adori. One day he simply ran out to me in the field, excited that he'd made some sort of a breakthrough, and he was going to head out on another trip. He never returned. From the journal you discovered, I'm sure you know the rest. Back to work.